No matter if we're talking about games, television, or movies, taxi cab drivers have always been portrayed as being a bit crazy. But I'm not sure that's the word I'd use to describe Lina Romero, the driver at the center of the new game Neo Cab. This is a normal, level-headed woman who came to the city of Los Ojos looking for a new start. There's nothing crazy about that. But when her friend goes missing and she gets caught up in a criminal conspiracy against the biggest corporation in the world, Lina will see her life get flipped upside down and changed in unthinkable ways. Yeah, all this might sound insane, but don't go into Neo Cab expecting Crazy Taxi. It's the near future, and self-driving cars are beginning to make taxi drivers a thing of the past. Lina drives for an Uber-like company named Neo Cab, which is one of the last remaining taxi services to employ real people. But this practice may be coming to an end if the overbearing tech company Capra has any say in the matter. On top of controlling almost every aspect of your life, from money to housing to entertainment, Capra is also trying to outlaw human-operated taxi cabs. Of course, Lina isn't aware of any of this as she heads towards Los Ojos. All she knows is that her former best friend Savvy has a spare room for rent, and the prospect of starting a new life in the big city sounds appealing. But this plan is undone when Savvy goes missing. Without a place to stay and very little money, Lina is forced to tirelessly work at Neo Cab in order to keep her head above water. She'll do all this while investigating clues in an effort to find Savvy and solve the larger mysteries found in the seedy underbelly of Los Ojos. As a Neo Cab driver, a lot of the job involves chatting with the passengers and making sure they give you a 5-star rating. So much of the early part of the game feels like a series of random sketches, with each passenger, or PAX as they call them in the future, forcing Lina into a lot of different and weird conversations. There are these two guys from Germany who refuse to believe that Lina is actually a real person and not a robot. There's an actor bouncing ideas off of our friendly driver. There's an insecure woman meeting her long-distance boyfriend for the very first time. And there's even a fake doctor who may or may not be romantically interested in our unattached cabbie. The goal is to earn at least 35 Capra coins and pick up as many as 3 different PAXs per day. Lina will need to refuel from time to time and make sleeping arrangements at the end of each shift. If she can maintain a rating of at least 4 stars, then she'll be able to keep her job at Neo Cab and live to see another day. But watch out for those 1-star reviews, because it's going to limit who you can pick up and how much Lina will be able to make. The trick is to keep everybody happy and make sure they all want to recommend Neo Cab. Now, it's actually a lot more complicated than that, because we're also actively investigating what happened to Savvy. Sometimes the people in the backseat will actually have useful information that will broaden the search. But Lina can't push too hard without possibly sacrificing a good rating. There's a real tug-of-war between keeping the PAX happy and furthering the storyline. Sometimes the dialogue options will seem straightforward, while other times they'll lead in directions that just leave everybody pissed off. It's especially difficult because every passenger is different, and sometimes their expectations are unreasonable, maybe even illegal. Now, it's important to note that Neo Cab is not a driving game. Despite being behind the wheel most of the time, we're never actually given control of the car. Our interaction is largely limited to choosing dialogue options and deciding who to pick up. Look, I don't mind the focus is entirely on the story and characters, but you know, it would have been nice to see more interaction. Everything from the camera angles, to the backgrounds, to the facial expressions, all repeat with each PAX. And if I'm being honest, that started to wear on me after a while. You know, I was actually reminded of the game Wheels of Aurelia while playing Neo Cab. That was another car-based interactive story that was just all about the dialogue and characters. But what it also did was it put you in control of driving through the cities and countrysides. Neo Cab needed that extra layer of interaction, even if it really wasn't about the driving. For as interesting as I found the mysteries and conversations, I couldn't shake that I was merely along for the ride. The other problem is that the story ends just as it's getting interesting. One of the things that I really like about this game is how ready it is to bring up heavy social and political topics that don't have easy answers. There's a lot to explore when it comes to the way technology replaces low-wage workers and the evils that come from major corporations controlling every aspect of our lives. So much of this game feels like an intoxicating mix between taxicab confessionals and Black Mirror. And I gotta admit that that's exactly why I was initially excited to see where the story went. Sadly, none of this pays off in a satisfying way. There's a point in the game where the curtain is pulled back and we suddenly understand everything that's going on. This really should have led to a whole new part of the game where that knowledge colors every conversation you have, both in good and bad ways. I was excited to take that information I learned and convince the people I had met along the way to help with the good fight and connect all the dots. But there's just nothing like that here. Instead, what we get is a few lines that explain what happens and then a brief coda. It left me a little angry that I was robbed of the most exciting part of the game. Of course, the saving grace here is there are quite a few different paths to take and characters to interact with. There's a lot of value in going back and seeing how things play out if you make different choices. This may not lead you to a more satisfying ending, but it will give you more time to enjoy the colorful cast of characters and their crazy conversations. And when it comes right down to it, that's the best part of Neo Camp. Sharp writing and a great cast of characters can't save Neo Cab from a repetitive presentation and an abrupt conclusion. There's a lot to like about the weird and often funny conversations that cab driver Lina gets into, and I like how the mystery unfolds little by little. The problem is that the most exciting part of the game is reduced to just a few lines of narration at the end, making a lot of the journey feel kinda pointless. I don't know, maybe it's just me, but driving a taxi through a neon-filled futuristic city should be a lot more fun than this. Hey, thanks for watching our review. If you liked what you saw here, then you should know that we post new reviews and features almost every day. Now here's the question I have for you. In what video game world do you want to work as a cab driver? Just think about driving around the game and talking to the locals. There are a ton of opportunities here, so let me see your thoughts in the comments below. In other news, we'll be back tomorrow with a review of Candleman, followed by Cubics, Demoniaca, and more. While I work on those, I strongly recommend you click that subscribe button and support what we're doing here. Until then.